From 1775 to 1783, America fought Great Britain for independence. This conflict was called the Revolutionary War. Against all odds, America won. What had been the 13 original colonies officially became the United States of America. After gaining independence, the American people did not want kings or queens governing them anymore. Americans wanted to create a new kind of government. They wanted to be able to elect individuals to represent the people and act with their best interests in mind. They wanted a government that was by the people, for the people. Represent means to speak for or take action in place of someone else. So they wanted to elect people who would be able to speak for and govern them with their best interests in mind. To help create the new form of government, several elected leaders met in Philadelphia in May and June of 1787. Some leaders who could not attend, such as Thomas Jefferson and John Adams, wrote down their ideas. Remember, Thomas Jefferson was the third president, and John Adams was the second president. Together, this group of leaders became known as the Founding Fathers. The Founding Fathers' ideas all came together in a document called the U.S. Constitution. The Constitution became the framework for the American government. A framework is the basic structure of something. A man named James Madison had a clear vision of how the United States should govern itself. James Madison is known as the father of the Constitution because he put all of the ideas together by writing the Constitution with the help of George Washington and others. He also became the fourth president of the United States. For many years after the Revolutionary War, the United States grew larger and wealthier. New states such as Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, and Louisiana were added. New territories were also settled. In 1803, President Thomas Jefferson purchased the Louisiana Territory from France. This purchase more than doubled the size of the United States. Meanwhile, across the Atlantic, France and Britain went to war against each other. This series of wars became known as the Napoleonic Wars, named after the French leader at the time, Napoleon Bonaparte. Napoleon Bonaparte wanted to make France the most powerful nation in the world. Britain was determined to stop him. The United States considered both France and Great Britain to be its friends. It did not want to get involved in these costly and destructive wars. Even though the Napoleonic Wars were being fought all the way across the Atlantic Ocean, they greatly affected the United States. Much of the United States' growth during this time depended upon trade with France and Great Britain. Trade refers to the business of buying and selling goods. Britain and France had many merchant or trading ships. These ships sailed across the Atlantic to trade goods with the United States, Canada, and with many of the British and French-owned islands in the Caribbean. For example, the United States sent flour and tobacco to France and Great Britain. Great Britain and France received sugar and coffee, or cocoa, from other countries. Both countries wanted to stop the other from trading with the United States. They also tried to prevent the other from getting money and supplies. They also did not want the United States to choose sides. To keep the French from trading with the United States, the British blockaded, or blocked, several U.S. ports. They also blocked several important ports in Europe. This seriously hurt U.S. trade. France and Britain both had large naval fleets positioned in the Atlantic Ocean to attack each other's ships. To make matters worse, the British and the French began to seize or capture American ships loaded with valuable cargo. It became almost impossible to safely transport goods from the United States to foreign ports. It was also more and more difficult for Americans to receive much-needed goods. Merchant ships weren't the only ships in the sea. The United States and Great Britain also had naval ships. Life in the British Navy was not easy. Conditions on their naval ships were terrible, and punishments were harsh. Because of this, the British Navy had a hard time finding men who wanted to be sailors. To get more sailors, the British began to capture men from other countries' ships and force them to join the British Navy. Sometimes these sailors were British deserters. A deserter is someone who runs away from military duty. However, more times than not, the sailors who were seized weren't even British. But that did not stop the British from doing it. They even seized many U.S. sailors. This practice of forcing men into the British Navy was called impressment. The impressment of U.S. citizens upset the American people and the U.S. government. As time went on, the United States found that it was losing more and more valuable cargo, sailors, money, and even ships. They demanded that the British stop impressing American sailors, but the British refused.